In this screencast, we will begin to explore the concept of feedback using the blending process. The blending process consists of two streams coming into a well-mixed tank. Then this liquid leaves through a single tank. So we're blending the two streams together, and we will continue to focus on the control variable of X, which is the mass fraction of species A in the tank. And our manipulated variable will continue to be W2, the mass flow rate in stream 2. Here we will adjust the manipulated variable automatically based on the measured value of the control variable. And in this example, we will consider a proportional control law where we adjust W2 prime, our flow rate and deviation variables, according to the error. So we'll have a proportionality constant Kp that we need to design. We need to design its value. And then we will take our desired value for x, the set point value, subtract from it the actual measured value, and use that to adjust W2. So we can define this quantity here as E, the error. We can then calculate the Laplace transform, and we can calculate the transfer function for the controller as well. The transfer functions are helpful when constructing block diagrams, when we put together our process model with our controller model. So previously, we had considered a linear model of the process, dx prime dt equals. So here, the value of x depends not only on the current value, but the change in x also depends on the two flow rates coming in. In this example, we're not considering any deviations in the flow rate of stream 1. Previously, that was our disturbance variable in previous screencasts. But here we'll assume that's not deviating, and we're really focusing on how we can achieve our desired value of x by adjusting W2. So next we'll take the Laplace transform to get our process transfer function. We will assume that we have no initial deviation in x, and then we will combine terms to get our transfer function. And finally, we can combine all of that together into process transfer function. Now that we have the transfer functions for the controller and for the process, we can put it all together in a block diagram. So the input to our controller is the error between the set point and the desired value. Based on the controller, we calculate W2 prime. W2 acts on the system. It's the manipulated variable. So that's the input to our process, GP. And then the output is X prime, our mass fraction, and that's our control variable. So when we close the loop, we feed back our control variable X, and we calculate the error as the difference between our set point value for X, summation sign, and the actual value for X. So we have a plus sign on the set point, and then we subtract from it the actual measured value. So this gives us our feedback loop. Now that we have our controller and our process coupled together in this loop, we can calculate the dynamics of the closed loop system. One thing to notice here is that W2 originally was the input to our process. It was our manipulated variable. But with the closed loop system, it's no longer an input, it's calculated. And the input to the system is actually the set point value for X. But we can go ahead and calculate now how X depends on the input of the set point. So X prime is equal to GP times W2 prime, but W2 prime is equal to GC times the error. And the error is equal to X set point prime minus X. Again, we can rearrange and we can calculate how X prime depends on X set point. So let's go ahead and collect terms. Now we can go ahead and we can define our closed loop transfer function, G closed loop, which is equal to X prime of S over X prime set point of X. And that's just equal to GP GC over 1 plus GP GC. And notice we've left off some S's on some of these terms. Sometimes we just do that for convenience, but really all of those terms do depend on S. And finally, we can go ahead and plug in the expressions for GP and GC for the blending process. And when we do that, we get negative 2.5 times 10 to the minus 6 times KP. KP was in GC, our controller transfer function. And then we can divide by 1 plus GPGC. So if we multiply top and bottom at the same time by the denominator of our process transfer function, we can get this simplified expression. So this is our closed loop transfer function for the blending process. And you can see that the gain, as well as the constant in the denominator, which is related to the time constant, those both depend on our choice of KP, the proportionality constant in the controller. So as an engineer, we need to design our controller such that we get good closed loop behavior. And then you might ask, well, what is good closed loop behavior? Well, here, we would really like for X to track our set point or desired value. So that means we would really like to achieve G closed loop of 1 all of the time so that X prime equals X prime set point. Although that's not always possible or practical, and we'll see examples of that in future screencasts.